PoPolitickin.com.
What's going on? It's your boy, Baby Jesus, aka the baby, and I'm on Po Politickin show, man, kicking it with him, politickin the right way.
Oh my God! Hey, I got right back to the bag. I got right back on my swag. I got right back to the cash. I got right back on the ass.
Oh yeah,
I'ma pull up at the gas.
Let go.
And pull right back up, make a mad. Whenever I see him, I laugh.
Ah.
Cause I got right back on the ass. Turn up. I got right back on the ass.
Turn up.
I got right back on the ass.
Turn up.
I got right back on the ass.
Oh yeah,
I got right back on the ass.
Oh yeah,
I got right back on the ass.
Turn up.
I got right back on the ass.
Let go.
I got right back to the crash.
Hey.
Now I'm right back on the ass.
Dang.
Okay. You know that they call me the baby.
Okay.
You know that my swag is so crazy.
Oh yeah,
and you know that I bag your little lady,
bag your love,
and we might end up having a baby.
No, I go.
Didn't know that I had that much play. I gave out so much sauce to these little niggas, I had to go put up a little bit for later. I really don't wanna talk to these little niggas, cause all they gon' do is turn into some hate. I won't even do these little niggas a favor. Back on their ass, I couldn't tell.
God damn,
I got right back to the bag. I got right back on my swag. I got right back to the cash. I got right back on the ass.
Oh yeah,
I'ma pull up at the gas.
Let go.
And pull right back up, make a mad. Whenever I see him, I laugh.
Ah.
Cause I got right back on the ass.
Turn up.
I got right back on the ass.
Turn up.
I got right back on the ass.
Turn up.
I got right back on the ass.
Oh yeah,
I got right back on the ass.
Oh yeah,
I got right back on the ass.
Turn up.
I got right back on the ass.
Let go.
I got right back to the crash.
Hey.
Now I'm right back on the ass.
Welcome back to PoPolitickin.com. Make sure you subscribe on YouTube, Facebook, all that. Chilling with my homie, Charlotte, North Carolina, emcee, DaBaby, a.k.a. Baby Jesus. What's good, bro?
What's going on, Pimp? Baby Jesus, a.k.a. DaBaby. Appreciate you ringing me, man. What's going on?
I'm great, man. So just talk about your name. What Baby Jesus, a.k.a. Baby Jesus. I mean, DaBaby. Talk about why they call you Baby Jesus.
Right, you know, it was actually kind of, you know, I like to say it's God-given, you know. It kind of just stuck with me. The first song I ever recorded when I went in the real studio is a song I got called I Think I'm Baby Jesus. And when I recorded that song, I ain't even have a rap name yet. You know what I'm saying? The producer, you know, when he was saving the song after we got done, he like, okay, what's your name? And I'm like, bro, I don't even got a name yet. Just say the song. And, you know, because I knew when I did come up with a name, I wanted it to be something that ring, like I wasn't never with no, you know, just did everything I do, like I wanted to have that ring to it. So, you know, I slept on it for about a week or two, and then I'm like, damn, Baby Jesus. So that's what I ended up running with, and it fit me, you know what I'm saying? And it got me this far. So, you know, that's where that came from. And DaBaby, that's just more of an alternative, you know, for anybody who not comfortable with saying Baby Jesus. Of course, you know, I don't want to miss out on that one listener because of the name. I feel like, you know, the movement and the music is bigger than all that.
All right. And then talk about your background a little bit. How long you been in the game? How you got started?
It's going on 2 years. It ain't even been 2 years yet. In December, it'll be 2 years. I ain't even rapping for 2 years. You know what I'm saying? I really, you know, I was at a point in my life where, you know, I felt like I was doing and living the way that all these other, that the rappers is already on, everything they was talking about, like that was like my real life, you know, at like 22 years old. So, you know, I felt like, you know, I could put my real life on display better than, you know, the way they were doing it, whether they talking about their real life or not. But I pretty much, you know, I got bored. I had everything I had ever wanted, a couple cars, all that, and it still wasn't enough for me. You know, I wasn't satisfied with it. And I felt like, you know, had I started rapping, I could rap better than the majority of the people that were rapping. And, you know, so I jumped out there. And you know, it took off just like that.
And then, like you were saying, you had the money, hoes, and clothes. So, was your background from the streets? Yeah, like, how you getting all that?
Yeah, definitely. You know, I definitely wasn't born with it. You know, I had to go out there and get it, you know, on my own. And see me seeing that happen, you know, I had already had the lifestyle. And I had already knew, you know what I'm saying, what it take to go from having nothing to getting everything you ever wanted. So, you know, me looking at the music game, like, I just love a challenge, you know what I'm saying? I love a challenge and I love, boom, you know, I love setting goals and accomplishing them. And I always, you know, set my goals, got high. And I ain't never, you know, not been able to to reach one of them. So, you know, that was just another goal for me. And, you know, I ain't saying it was easy like this. You know, I done put in plenty of work, you know, as an artist with the rap game and shit. And, but, you know, everything just paid off. I just kept it consistent and really put everything, you know, I put that whole lifestyle that I had on hold and then boom, put it all into the music. But yeah, definitely, you know, I did what I did to get to where I was at. And, you know, it definitely gave me a heads up because I had so many stories to tell from the lifestyle I was living. Like, you know, it's almost second nature. Like, when I go in the studio, like, it's not hard at all for me to come up with a song. Like, it, you know, like, what people find interesting, like, that's my everyday life. You know what I'm saying? What blows people's minds.
Well, I'm going to say, but so how you feel about that? Because, I mean, I always kind of look at rap kind of like wrestling. Like, everybody, I don't even, like, listen to people like that and be like, are they spitting for real? Because 9 times out of 10, I think they ain't real. And then, like, in wrestling, like, you got Brock Lesnar that's actually a real fighter and they don't respect him. So when you got the people that's actually real, it's kind of getting overlooked by most people ain't real.
Exactly. You know, you got to have the type of consistency and the type of hunger. You know, even though, like, if you was already straight, like, see, when I started rapping, like, I was already staying in a condo uptown, way up in the sky. You know what I'm saying? I was 22 years old. You know, like, that's what I'm at right now. And I ain't got no rap money yet. You know, I don't want to mess up the FaceTime with the dude if I put the phone up and, you know, pointed this way, the Panther Stadium. I'm looking at the stadium from the living room. So, I mean, it just, you know, it's levels to everything. You gotta outwork the people who lying about your lifestyle if it's like that. But I mean, I feel like at the end of the day, you know, real gonna recognize real, like it's gonna show. Like I don't really gotta scream to prove no point. Like I think my delivery, you know, in my songs and like, I don't know, like just how pure it is. Like it's so authentic, you know, I don't feel like it can get taken the wrong way. But don't get me wrong, because a lot of people that lie about the things they do, they sound real good lying about it.
Right.
But I ain't never, yeah, you know, I just made it a point jumping into the game to never tell a lie, like not one, you know, and it pays off at the end of the day. So, you know, for the people who do get by with telling lies, you know, that's cool. That's cool for them, but I couldn't sleep at night doing that, you know. So, I just stay in my lane and just do what I do and just keep it real.
So who are some of your influences?
I like Kevin Gates. Of course, me being, you know, 24, I grew up in that Lil Wayne era. So I'd be lying. Anybody my age would be lying to say Lil Wayne ain't influenced him some type of way. You know, he had the game on the block for years. You know, I like Game Changers, Kanye. I got to even say, you know, that I rock with Drake, you know, just by how diverse he is, you know, and how he's still able to tap into so many different markets, you know what I'm saying, at the same time, and then still be himself while doing it. So things like that, artists like that, I respect them type of artists.
So you kind of hit on it, but what would you say makes you unique and what are you bringing to the game?
Really, you know, I still make that music, you know, that you can have fun with. I still make that music that you could turn up to, but at the same time, it all has, like, my music has subject matter. You know, like, some people, you know, they make music that'll make you bob your head, it'll make you jump around and shit, but at the end of the day, they're not talking about nothing. You know, yeah. My music, it keeps all those other elements, and at the same time, I'm talking about something. You know what I'm saying? Like, my music will make you go from having a terrible day to feeling great, you know what I'm saying? Or I got songs that'll fuck around and make you cry, you know what I'm saying? And it all, but at the same time, it all still got that, you know, it still got that feel to it. It still got that bounce to it, every song I make. And at the same time, I got songs where I got the lyrical content. I can make R&B type shit for the females. Like, I'm so diverse, but so authentic at the same time. It's almost undeniable. It's something that's not in the game right now. So that's where it's going, you know, that's what's going to separate me from anybody, you know, anybody in the industry.
And who do you make your music for? Like, what type of fans do you...
Like, everybody. That's the thing. I can go here. I can go there. You know, so I got music that I can make for these types of people. I got music that people mama listen to. You know, people uncles, they cousins. I got, you know, I can go pretty much anywhere with it. I try to keep it, you know. I try to keep it in the one targeted area that shows me, like, you know, that shows me the best reaction to the music. But at the same time, like, I don't hold nothing back. I don't get, because I got the versatility with it. So, you know, just I don't put myself in one box when it comes to the music. Like, I don't take away from the art. Like, I just go with it. I don't got no comfort zone. Like, I do anything and still stay in my element while doing it. Like, that is my element, being able to do anything. And that's still me. You know, that's me. That's me outside of the music. Like, I can go in the hood, any hood, talk to anybody in any hood, and then I could walk into a $1 million business and greet the millionaires like I'm one of them. Like, I just always had that type of versatility, so I can do those types of things, and that shows in my music.
And then you was talking about the art, so what are some ways that I guess rappers can improve in their craft and become a better MC?
Really, you know, not. I don't know. I mean, I say just letting it go anywhere. You know, not being afraid to step outside of their comfort zone, and you know, just do whatever. You know, like that's what get a lot of people far. Some people feel, you know, people feel certain types of ways about it, but see, that you should care about that. If your goal is to appeal to one particular audience, see me, like, I want everybody. I want everybody. I want the white people, the black people. I want the people overseas. I want your grandma listening to it. I want your kids to grow up listening to it and talk about you the rest of their life. I want all them types of fans. But see, if you just want, you know, if you just want the people in the hood to listen to your music, then okay, stay in that box and, you know, only make trap music. You know, if that's what you want, if that's what floats your boat. But see, I want people in the hood. I want the people, I want the college students, I want the grown-ups, I want the people that was born, you know, in the generation before me. I want the people that's coming in the generation after me. So, I mean, the best advice I can give to any artist is to just, you know, don't put yourself in a box and just remain open to anything. Remain open to any and everything. That's what I do. You know, I'm not afraid to go anywhere with it. I walk in the studio and make an R&B song. I can't even sing. I go in there and make an R&B song, man, and people... I got a couple songs now. People are like, yeah, who is that singing on the hook? I'm like, yeah, that's me, you know, and it blow people's mind. You know what I'm saying? But you know, you just gotta not be afraid to go anywhere. That's what'll make you stand out at the end of the day.
All right, and now would you talk about your current projects? I saw you came out with the God's Work.
Yeah, God's Work Resurrected. Like, I just came out with a reloaded version of God's Work. God's Work, that's on iTunes, Apple Music, Tidal, Amazon, pretty much any digital distribution site. And we just put out God's Work Resurrected. That's a reloaded version of God's Work. That's out on DatPiff, SoundCloud, AudioMac.com. And that one is pretty much the same as the first mixtape, with just four additional songs, but I took away like two songs from the first project. So it give it more of a mixtape feel, whereas mm-hmm. God's Work, that's like an album. Like, that's like, you know, that one should have went platinum, but I put it out as a mixtape. You know, like, I was blessed enough to be able to create a body of work like that early in my career. You know what I'm saying? Before, like, I even blew up, like, I got a body of work that, you know, once everything do blow, people gonna go back to that. Like, damn, you know what I'm saying? Like, he gave this away for free. So the God's Work Resurrected, that's more of like a mixtape feel. And it's pretty much to put the stamp on an alternative name, DaBaby. Plus, it gets it out to the ears that didn't catch the first project.
All right. And then, like, what's your website and everything, like social media?
Right. Social media is at BabyJesus704. That's Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, all of the above. And if you are a Facebook user, you can just search Baby Jesus or DaBaby, and it'll pop up that way. But at BabyJesus704.
And what's some of your interests and hobbies outside of music?
I don't know. I just got into working out, man. I be in the gym a lot. I just got into working out. And, you know, shit, I like to eat good. Yeah, I like to eat good every now and then. You know, we pop the Hennessy open. You know, I just like to have fun all around. I'm just a fun person altogether. So, you know, outside of music, you know, anything fun. And I just recently got on my whole healthy thing. So, you know, I be in the gym and I like looking good, you know, and when I saw them results, now I can't stay out of that gym. So, you know, I'm all about, Yeah, I'm all about that though, man. You know, I just like to have fun above anything.
And then far as the music business, like, what advice would you give people? Because they always say, "Oh, make sure you know the business." So, what advice would you give a new artist?
Yeah, you got to fall in love with the work before you even think about the lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? Because the lifestyle is work. Like, it's not really, you know, peaches and cream like people make it seem. You know what I'm saying? Like girls and all that other shit. Like, you got to fall in love with the grind, because if you're not in love with the grind, you're not going to get there. And even if you do get there, don't get me wrong, some people, they take off overnight, they go viral. But if you don't got that grind and that work ethic to follow up with it, you got to think about all the people who done blew up with a song, and now you're fucking around to see them in Walmart somewhere, you know, looking like they're hurting. You know, you gotta fall in love with that grind. You gotta come in with that work ethic. That's what's gonna keep you in the game. That's what's gonna take you far, you know. And that gotta be number one. You know, that work ethic gotta be there, because it ain't easy at all. It ain't easy at all. And that's just getting to where I'm at right now, and I still got a long way to go. You know, so it's all work, no play. You gotta play later on. You ain't gonna get to play for a couple years.
All right, man. I want to say thank you for coming to Politickin with me.
No doubt, no doubt. I appreciate you having me.
You had any last words you want to hit them with? Will they check you out, anything?
Oh, yeah, no doubt. You know, once again, our social media sites, that's @babyjesus704, that's Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, all of the above. Get at me, I'm going to get back at you. I do not bite. Baby Jesus, a.k.a. the baby. Phone fell on me, and we back. But, yeah, man, that's it.
You're listening to PoPolitickin.com. We got you stuck. Got you stuck off the realness.
Stop.
Yeah.
First of the day.
Yeah. I got a whole lot of diamonds. Yeah. Whole lot of gold on my neck, so a young nigga shining. Add up the check with my niggas and we gon' divide it. Yeah. And I'ma make niggas respect it, a young nigga grinding. I got a whole lot of diamonds. Whole lot of gold on my neck, so a young nigga shining. Add up the check with my niggas and we gon' divide it. And I'ma make niggas respect it, a young nigga grinding. So much gold around my neck, I look like Mr. T. I say this with all due respect, you not fucking with me.
No.
I need somebody to help me, I'm having a problem.
Hey.
Like, should I just put on my gold or should I wear the diamonds? When I pull up on the most, I got all of them smiling. Run up that check with my bros and then we gon' divide it.
Hey.
I promise that I never focus, a young nigga solid.
Hey.
And wherever a young nigga go, I'ma always be shining. Hey. Yeah. I got a whole lot of diamonds.
Yeah.
Whole lot of gold on my neck, so a young nigga shining. Add up the check with my niggas and we gon' divide it.
Yeah.
And I'ma make niggas respect it, a young nigga grindin'. I got a whole lot of diamonds. Whole lot of gold on my neck, so a young nigga shining. Add up the check with my niggas and we gon' divide it. And I'ma make niggas respect it, a young nigga grindin'. I'ma make niggas respect it, a young nigga be on the grind. She started real with the S's, a young nigga be on the mind. Whole lot of ice on my body, be careful, don't slip on the water. Looking like I'm from Miami, they thinking young nigga from Florida.
Yeah.
Only young nigga in Charlotte is rocking a whole lot of diamonds.
Dime.
You making somebody too if your Cuban link costs 20,000. Got the same jewelry as Future, this chain was made by Aviani. Whole lot of niggas was sleeping, I had to get up and remind them. I got a whole lot of diamonds.
Yeah.
Whole lot of gold on my neck, so a young nigga shining. Add up the check with my niggas and we gon' divide it.
Yeah.
And I'ma make niggas respect it, a young nigga grinding. I got a whole lot of diamonds. Whole lot of gold on my neck, so a young nigga shining. Add up the check with my niggas and we gon' divide it.